Hey everybody, Robbie and Pete here again. We're going to be teaching you another maneuver today. We're going to be teaching just general taxiing, so just a general hover taxi. So that means we're going to stay fairly close to the ground and just maneuvering down a taxiway. So the whole purpose here is just to get that helicopter moving in forward direction, get from point A to point B, usually in an airport environment. The first thing that we're going to do is clear our area. We're going to look all the way around us, make sure that you don't have any people walking up to you, there's no buildings, obstacles, anything like that, really getting a good view of what's going on. Just like many of the other hovering maneuvers, we're going to make sure that our eyes are out at the horizon and not just staring down at the ground right in front of us or anything. Really give us a wide view for safety, and it helps with the controllability of the aircraft as well. Then we're going to initiate our forward movement with just a slight forward pressure on the cyclic. If you push forward too fast, you'll actually start a sink. If you do this right initially, you really shouldn't need very much collective input, maybe just a little bit so you don't sink too much, but this should be minimal collective and just really slight forward pressure on that cyclic moving forward, just like Pete's doing right now. We're going to end up controlling our heading with our pedals. So if we start kind of twisting to the left or the right a little bit, yawing, we'll just use those pedals to make sure that we are pointed straight down the runway. That's going to be the safest thing in case we have any kind of issues or anything where we start descending towards the ground. We want those skids pointed right down the runway. We're going to be using that cyclic to control our position so that the center line is right down the center of the aircraft. And then we're going to be using our skid height with our collective, and we want that 3 to 5 foot skid height. As far as a pace goes or an airspeed goes, we just want a brisk walking pace. So whatever you would do out on the ground, just walking fast, right, briskly, that's how fast we want to be taxiing. And then really just focusing on keeping those skids parallel with the runway, with the taxiway, whatever you're taxiing on, because that's going to be the safest configuration for that. As far as standards go for the ACS, for the FAA, when you go to your check rides, our heading needs to be plus or minus 10 degrees. That's both for private and commercial. Our altitude needs to be plus or minus 2 feet, and our ground track plus or minus 4 feet for private and 2 feet for our commercial standards. Now, a couple of considerations and/or common errors that we see with this. If you have a crosswind with this, what you're going to want to do is dip that rotor, that main rotor, into the wind just enough so that you can keep that ground track. So we don't want to be trying to use our pedals or anything like that to counteract a crosswind. We want to use that cyclic and just a little bit of tilt into that crosswind. Another issue that we see a lot of times is people not clearing their area before they start moving forward in the taxi. So make sure that you've really cleared the area really well. And then one of the biggest things with this is that you're not over controlling the aircraft. Remember, we fly helicopters with pressures, not necessarily movements. So just really slow, smooth on all of those control inputs. Especially you start getting some gusty winds, some crosswinds and things, people tend to get a little bit stabby with their cyclic and with their pedals. We want to keep everything just gentle and smooth. That, my friends, is how we hover taxi. Move ourselves around the airport environment nice and safe, nice and smooth. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you next time.